What's going on YouTube and welcome back to the channel, Team Gradelock here. Of course, I'm your host, Henry Rico from Team Gradelock, and today is our Cardfight Vanguard Standard Market Watch, meaning in this video, we're going to go over cards in a standard format to see which cards are money, which cards are minus, and which cards are plus. But before we begin, please remember to comment, like, subscribe, check out our channel for more videos, such as deck profiles, match videos, more Market Watch videos. Every Thursday is going to be our standard Market Watch, and every Friday is going to be our Cardfight Vanguard Premium Market Watch. So stay tuned for tomorrow. But before we start the Market Watch, if you guys want to show any love and support to the channel, we have a link down below in our description box. If you click it, it'll take you directly to tcgplay.com. Any purchase that you make on tcgplay.com off of our link, we get a small percentage and it is no extra cost whatsoever. So any support that we do receive, we greatly, greatly do appreciate it. So today's Market Watch is going to be very spicy. A few buyouts, a lot of cards are overpriced, and a few cards you guys should be looking out for. Now, the first card I want to talk about is the Cosmo Healer. The SVR is above the market price at $30 with 10 listings. $30, the SVR, even though the VR only goes for $5 to $6. Well, technically the VR is above its own market price, but the SVR has tripled in price, which is insane. Overall, a lot of cards in this set in BTO7s have actually been gaining value, mainly the triple R's, and I'm going to show you why. Alright, so the first triple R, that's almost $10. The Astraea of Full Heavens, the triple R's, are now $8. It's about to be a $9 card with only 7 listings. So this is the first triple R that's actually about to be $10 in the actual booster set. Usually triple R's and booster sets, they don't gain this much value until maybe like a month or two later. But this triple R has been gaining value ever since it first came out. It used to be $2, then $3, and then eventually $5, and now it's heading towards the $8 to $9 range. So if you guys actually have this triple R for Genesis, they're only gaining value. Possibly $8 might be the highest, maybe it might go down, but as it looks right now, there's only 7 listings. But if you have them, I recommend to get rid of them because it looks like people are actually buying them for $7 to $8. Now let's see what other triple R's we can find. Fusion Striker is $3, $3. Starfighter Silverfist are $4. It's above the market price. It's basically $3.69 to $4 with 14 listings. Let's see what we can find. The other grade 2 for Genesis, the triple R's, are $3. And Evil Stealth Dragon Zangetsu are $2 and change. Evil Stealth Dragon Korrigis are $2. Overall, all the triple R's in this set actually value. Usually in main booster sets, not all the rares are a dollar. Not all the triple R's are dollars. A lot of triple R's in the main booster sets are usually like 50 cents or maybe even 89 cents, but a lot of them are above a dollar, and there's a few of them that are actually above $3, which is actually pretty good. So if you guys actually bought a case of this set, you guys are making back your money, because a lot of triple R's in this set are definitely gaining value. Now, I know we talked about this card in the last Market Watch and the Market Watch before that, but it still amazes me how the SVR is still above the market price at $20, while the VR are still bought off the market with only 2 listings. One for $15 and change, after that, $20 and change. Well, technically $21 and change. That is insane. So, basically, instead of buying the VR for $15 and change, you're better off just buying the SVR, because apparently the VR is about to be $20, which in my opinion I don't agree with. This card, the VR shouldn't be more than $15. It's my opinion. I could be right, could be wrong. Comment down below. Let me know what you guys think. Another card that we talked about in the last Market Watch, Ultra Beast Deity Aluminum Dragons, the triple R's. They used to be $7 to $8. Well, technically $9. Now they're down to $5 with 16 listings. A lot of you guys have been asking me, Rico, why did this happen? The main reason is because a lot of people undercut other people on prices. That's one of them. The second main reason, which I think is more important than the first one, the card is not that much in demand anymore. I understand. Everyone's building God Hand, and if you're building God Hand, you need this grade 3 in your God Hand build. But it looks like a lot of people are just not that interested anymore, because again, there's 16 listings. In almost each listings, there's multiple copies in each listing. So it looks like the demand for this card is just not there anymore as it used to be. So with that, it just keeps stocking up in pile, and people just keep undercutting people on prices, which of course lowers down the prices on cards. But again, I don't think undercutting people on prices doesn't really change the market value. The only thing that changes the market value is if the card is in demand. And right now at the moment, unfortunately, this card is not in demand and it's down to $5. Which is pretty sad, because this card used to be $9, eventually heading towards the $10 range. Now, one of my teammates brought this up to me, which I didn't believe until I actually looked at it. Waving the leader, a Griddle. The SVRs are still $9-$10, hasn't really changed, but the VRs, they're going up to $9. They're above their market price at $8 and change. So technically the VR is almost a dollar away from being the same price as the SVR. Which kind of makes no sense, because if you actually look at it, there's 16 listings for the VR. So why would the VR go up in value above the market price? Which makes no sense. In my honest opinion, I feel like this price is not real. It's hype. It shouldn't be more than $5 in my honest opinion. This VR is not a bad VR, don't get me wrong. But the only issue is that this grade 3 doesn't really do anything else after the turn after it rides. Because this card, his main effect, his good effect, is the on-ride skill. That's it. So again, I could be right, could be wrong. Comment down below, let me know what you guys think, but do not buy this card for more than $5. The VR is not worth more than $5, especially $8. That's just insane. Another card that people have brought my attention to, Phantom Blaster Dragon, the SVRs are still $6 to $7. That hasn't changed, with 30 listings, by the way. 30 listings for the SVR. But the VR, there's 21 listings, and apparently they're $8 and change, heading towards the $9 range, and then $10 range. So apparently the VRs are more expensive than the SVR. This is a messed up world that we live in. Like, I don't understand where people are getting these numbers from. Why is the VR more expensive than the SVR? Because I'm sorry guys, it just makes no sense whatsoever. In all honesty, I want to laugh, but I want to keep my professionalism. I want to be professional throughout the market watch. But it's getting difficult, because people just keep putting up these insane prices. The VR, more expensive than the SVR. Also, another card that's going up in the market, White Lily Musketeer Cecilia's. The VRs, they used to be $15. Well, the market price was 15, but this card was going down in value, but now it's actually going up in value. We are getting more Neonactive support. It's around the corner. Right now, at the moment, they're going for $17 and change. After that, $18, and then eventually skipping towards the $20 range. So if you guys haven't picked up your Cecilia's yet, I recommend to pick them up now, because potentially this VR might become a $20 card again. Don't forget about Angel Feathers. This grade 2 Angel Feather from EBO3 is $9 to $10 with 6 listings. This RRR grade 2 is still value, holding at $9 to $10. Well, technically there's only one listing for $9, after that $10. But it gets better. Crimson Impact Metatron. The RRRs are still $9 to $10 with 7 listings. So again, the hype train for Angel Feathers are real, mainly for the grade 3 and the grade 2 RRRs. I figured to just bring this up. Battlefield Storm Sagramores, the double Rs, are slightly going up in the market, and I don't think you guys should sleep on it. There's 11 listings. There's a few of them for less than $3. After that, $3 and change, eventually heading towards the $5 range. Now I'm pretty sure it will go towards the $5 range eventually, pretty soon actually, because if you look at these listings, there's only one copy in each listing until $5 with 8 copies. So potentially Sagramores might become a $5 card. I wouldn't be surprised, because this grade 3 is a phenomenal grade 3 in standard and premium format. Oh look, we're going to talk about a Tachikaze card. A Tachikaze card that's going up in the market, which we haven't talked about in a while, by the way. Ravenous Dragon and Mega Rexes, they look like they're $6 to $7. There is 13 listings, but only one of them for less than $10. After that, $10 and change. So Mega Rexes, if you guys actually have them, they're not $7, they're $10, because they're flying off the shelves. I've seen a few listings for this card on eBay for like $8-$9, but on the sold listings, So people are actually buying them off eBay for even $8 to $9. So I am pretty sure this card is a $9 to $10 card, just for the fact that Tajikazes are still seeing a few, still seeing a little bit of meta play out there. And another Tajikaze card that I want to talk about, Sonic Noah. It looks like it's $2 and change, but there is only 11 listings, and it's heading towards a $3 to $4 range, and eventually $5. If you guys actually have this double R grade 1, it is not a dollar anymore, it is not $2 anymore. This grade 1 Sonic Noah is a phenomenal grade 1 for Tachikazes. Potentially it might see some play in premium format, but mainly standard format, Sonic Noahs are definitely value, holding at $3 and more. And the last card that I want to talk about is Stealth Rogue of Indignation Mamoru. This card is disgusting and it insults me, it insults every vendor out there. This triple R box topper is going for $50 and then eventually $60. But it gets better. The non-triple R versions are going for $40. Come on. Honestly, fine. I understand. Murakumos are still a meta deck. Murakumos are still seeing a few are still seeing meta play because of the last VR. But $40 for a box topper promo grade 2. Nah, man, that's way too much money for my blood for a piece of cardboard. So that's the end of our Mark Watch for today. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you guys did indeed enjoy the video, please give it a thumbs up. If you guys haven't subscribed yet to our channel, I recommend to subscribe to our channel for more videos. Also, guys, if you guys want to support the channel or show us any love, and if you guys need to purchase any cards off tcgplay.com, click our link down below. It'll take you directly to the website, and any purchase whatsoever that you make, we get a small percentage of it, and it is no extra cost, and we greatly do appreciate it. Today's market watch was pretty spicy. A lot of cards are above the market price. A lot of cards shouldn't be above the market price. And this promo from Murakumos, it is disgusting how much it is. It is just insane. I love the Vanguard secondary market, but this is just, there's a good and a bad and an ugly to the secondary market for Cardfight Vanguard. This clearly is the ugly, because that price is just insane. And yeah. Alright guys, stay tuned for tomorrow's Market Watch for Cardfight Vanguard Premium Market Watch, and I will see you guys next time. Deuces.